This is Kenzo. It's Monday, it's early in the morning. So, as you can see here, the market is going down. It's going down. So, the bearish are very strong at the moment. So, let's go. It's a daily time frame. So, you can see on a daily time frame from this point, the market actually never recovered. All the candles are are just red candles. It shows you that the market is really going down because we are on a daily time frame. You can see that. So it's easy because you can see if maybe you're sold from this point, obviously you made something. So stuff like this happen all the time. So when the market is going up, it will be like this. It will be like this. You can see it's a daily time frame and all the candles were green. It means that even if the market rejects, but the overall picture, the market was just going up. You can see from this point, the market was just going up. You can see even here, when the market goes down, everything just turned to red. It means every day the market was just pushing down, even if maybe somewhere it creates fake bullish candlesticks, but the overall picture, the market is just going down. You can see from this point, the market was just pushing down. So it shows that there is a strong sell. You can see from here, the market was just buying. So if you got it somewhere here, then you were going to be in a very nice profit. So let's go to the 4 hour time frame and see what's really happening at the moment. So that's why I said I don't advise anyone to buy from that point, because you can see. So on a four, let me go to a 4 hour time frame. So if you forgot to hit that subscribe button, please hit that subscribe. Let me go on an hour. Hit that subscribe button. Let's grow the channel. It's free. Don't forget to hit like, so that other people they can learn something from this channel. So here I'm just gonna draw my usual trend line. You can see here. Whoa, the market is very close. The market is really pushing down, guys. So I don't usually like to draw this one, because since the market is going up, there is no point for me to draw this. I don't see a real reason why I should draw this, because when I enter, I only enter around this point. So I don't enter somewhere here. I don't buy the market when it's there, you see. So since the market it's going up, it's on a very nice uptrend. So I wait for the market to come near my support, then I buy. So around, if maybe the market it's here, I won't buy, I won't do anything. So I'll wait for the market to reach this point, then I can wait for the market to respect this point, then I can buy. If it doesn't, then it's where I do nothing. If maybe the market breaks this point, we'll be expecting the market to change the trend. It will be maybe in downtrend. So you can see even on a 4 hour. That's why I say people they should learn to use a bigger time frame. Using a bigger time frame, it doesn't mean maybe you are a swing trader. You hold your trades for a week or something. It just shows you that. It just shows you the bigger picture. You can see easily what's really going on. You can see here. I think maybe it's from the 16. Let me see. Now it's the from Tuesday last week. From Tuesday last week, the market was just going down. You can see on a 4 hour time frame, there is no green candlestick. You can see that it's very easy to see. But if you go to a smaller time frame, it's where you get confused. You will see different stuff. You can see, we are on an hour time frame. Let's see, 1 hour time frame. Whoa. On an hour time frame, it's where maybe I only use this 15 minutes and 1 hour time frame when I'm about to see the change or where I want to enter. You can see here we had something like this. We had something like, let me just. We had something like this. I think it was Friday. So the market was, you can see the market was just going down like this. The market was just going down like that. Then the market broke our resistance here. You can see that. So once the market broke here, I said on the group, I said we should just wait for, I think, sorry, let me just clear this. I think this thing was like this. Because, I think we drawn it like that. So I said if the market reaches here and respect here, you should buy. So the market came here, tried to respect this point. Yeah, it's something like this. The market did something. Let me just zoom. You can see very clearly what happened. So the market did something like this. The market broke here. Went up. Then we didn't do anything. When the market comes down here, we waited for something like this. Then I think we placed a buy, but we went out very early because the market just pushed down. But we made a very small profit. So, which means this was a just fake breakout. You can see that. So the market knew that most people are selling because it was just obvious the market is just going down. So that's why I said, if you still remember a few days ago, I said something like this. I want to show you something. Most of the time when the market, let me just go on a 4 hour time frame. I want to show you something. So let me just put. Okay, I said something like this. When the market breaks, the market was breaking this point. So I told you if the market break it and the market broke and came again and did a retest here. So it was a clear sell, but the market is clever because it won't just drop like this. You see, the market will make sure that you don't make money easily. The market will do something like, maybe let's say the market broke from here. It will just go retest, drop, something like this might happen. Sorry, this thing doesn't draw very nice. Something like this might happen. So the formation won't be clear for you. Even if you know that the market just broke here, but you can see here the market just retested here to show you that this is a it's a sell. So you sold maybe, then the market just came bounced back again. You can see that once you are on a very nice sell, the market bounced again. This one is much better, but look at this one. Obviously, maybe you did change your take profit and put it somewhere here, or maybe you locked your profit. Obviously, you'll be out at this point. So this run shows that there were few people in the market. Obviously, if you see these runs, you see people that were already closed, or maybe here the market tricked a few people. Like it's a buy, then once you all buy, the market just came fast. You can see that. So that's why I said I don't really buy the market when it's around here. So I will buy somewhere here. Then it's where I can say, okay, let me just risk this because it confirms with my analysis. But if it breaks this point, then I will close. Obviously, there will be my stop loss. Then maybe the market will be changing the trend. But you can see this is not a smooth trend, but it's going down. It's going down. So moves like this, yeah, they are made to disturb traders. If you use a very small time frame, you will be confused and you end up blowing your account because you just sold from this point. You made a small profit. You said maybe you want to log, then the market just went up, touch your maybe you locked the profit, then it touched it, you out. Once it touched that SL, the market just dropped. When you try to sell again, the market just went up. So the market is always on the other side, you see. So the best thing is try, even if you are not a long-term trader, like maybe you are not swing trader, you can try to have a nice entry from this point. That's what I do actually. If I entered somewhere here, unfortunately I don't sell NASDAQ at the moment because we are on a very nice uptrend, even if now it's going down. So what I do is if I entered maybe here, maybe I said I placed my sell here, I will place maybe my stop loss from this point and I will just ignore the my positions, because most of the time the market will just come around here, then you will just panic and close. So I check after a few hours, not after a few minutes. Then if maybe something has happened, maybe I'm in a small profit, I can just lock my profit. I don't put, if I place an order, I don't put my stop loss was here. I don't come and put my stop loss somewhere here. No, I don't do that. It has to be very close because this thing is very volatile. The market will just come around and touch your lock, if you're locked, obviously, if you're locked to your profit, the market will just come around there so that it can touch SL. So here it's clear, guys, it's clear. So at the moment we are just waiting for a very nice buy. We're waiting for a buy, so let's see what we can do from this point. It's easy if maybe you are not in a hurry, you see. So many things are easy in life if you can just let the time go. But if you just want to trade now and then, you will think the market is very slow. You will end up taking yourself from this point, you say, maybe just because it's going down, then you will lose. So it's better to wait and do other things. That's why you should do other things. You should have hobbies. Play some PS4 or PS5 games. Then when you come back, you will find your positions in a very nice profit. So at the moment, guys, we are waiting for the market to reach this point. I know the market won't reach this, it might not reach this point exactly, but as long as the market can be, if the market shows me anything that it shows that it's about to bounce back, yes, I can take a buy from that point. I can take a nice buy from this point. So there's no need to sell from this point. We will only sell if maybe. I don't really sell on NASDAQ, but I will only sell if something like this happen. If the market come to this point, breaks this point, and come here and retest, then it's where I can see, okay, the market is really going down. I can sell from that point. But if that is not happened yet, I'll be waiting for the market to reach this point. I don't know if maybe it will retest twice or what, but from this point I'm waiting for the market to be this point, and I think it will reach this point before the market opens. So please do check the market if maybe it does reach this point, because it can come and reach this point and start to consolidate from this point. The market will just consolidate until the market open. Or what I've realized with the market, sometimes when it's very close, because the market seems like it knows that people are trading, obviously. So the market will just come here, try to do a fake breakout like this one here. It's a 4 hour, it's a big thing, this thing. So it can create that tail. So once everyone is out, then the market will just come back and go up again. So be careful when you want to place the order from here. So the best thing that you can do, don't just place an order. Don't just place an order. Make sure you place your pending orders so that if the market just dropped, you are still safe. Because if maybe you just place a buy here, hoping that the market will just go up, the market might go up, you might be safe for a few trades, but on a long-term view, some trades you're gonna lose even if you show the right direction. So the best way is, if you are not used to use pending orders, please learn to use them. They are very useful. You just place your order and forget. You can even place your stop loss when the market just drop, you are safe. When the market comes back, it's when you know your position will be hit, then the market maybe will push. Maybe the market will push up. So thank you guys. Don't forget to hit the subscribe, also notification button, so that you don't miss other material that I will be sending daily. And please guys, don't forget to hit also a like button if you really think maybe the information was valuable. So thank you guys. Now we are waiting for a buy. We don't do anything at the moment, we're just waiting for a buy. Let's wait for the market to reach this point. So I also, now at the moment, I will be doing US 30. I think it's also dropping on that side. So let's see what's happening. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thank you guys.